conscious is the word we use for all the different things we don't yet understand about the mind. And the sooner we get rid of such words. Now, these words are very useful and we can't get rid of them. For example, suppose somebody kills somebody else by accident. They didn't intend to. Well, then there's no use punishing them, unless they're prone to do it all the time. In that case, you have to isolate them. But we need the word consciousness for ethical reasons, for fooling people into behaving the way we want. So we make the distinction between a decision somebody makes because of a complicated process we can't understand, but which we can interfere with. So you see, it's a legal and it's a social and an economic term that we really need. How do we control people? Well, we have to distinguish between the things that they do because of using these 30 or 40 different mental processes, because we can teach them not to, or we can warn them not to. Other kinds of processes that are lower level and involve less machinery are harder to interfere with. And so legally, there's no point in punishing them for things that in some sense weren't intentional, that they couldn't control. And so I'm saying that the reason the word consciousness is so popular is not because it has a scientific importance, it's because it has a political and social and economic importance. And I'm ashamed of my colleagues who don't understand the difference between cause and opportunity. It's maybe we don't have the right words to distinguish between the ways we need for describing people for different purposes.